إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة فصلوات الله وسلامه على رسول الله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على خير خلقك وأفضل رسلك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين وصحابته الغر الميامين والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أيها الإخوة الكرام يروي لنا عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي يحذرنا فيه من خمس أشياء ويستعيذ بالله وهو يخاطب المهاجرين أن تحصل لهم أو يدركوها فاسمعوا وعوا أيها الإخوة الكرام هذا الحديث يقول عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما أقبل علينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا معشر المهاجرين أو people of migration people who went from Mecca to Medina and migrated to establish Darul Islam, to establish the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the great support of people of Medina. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يجزي الله المهاجرين والأنصار خير الجزاء. He said, O people of مهاجرين, خمس إذا ابتليتم بهن وأعوذ بالله أن تدركوهن. Five things that this Muslim Ummah will be tested with. Five things this Muslim Ummah will be tested with. And I ask Allah, I refuge, ask Allah to protect you and seek refuge in Allah to protect you from these things. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I hope that you will not see these things. You will not face them. He's telling his own muhajirin min ali al-bayt wa sahaba radiyallahu anhum. Idha btulaytum bihunna wa a'udhu billahi an tudrikuhunna. Imagine if somebody say a'udhu billahi from something. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أعوذ بالله من الفواحش أعوذ بالله من غضب الله أعوذ بالله. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all bad things. That means these five things are so bad to the extent that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua that the muhajirin not to face them, not to see them, not to live to that time. لم تظهر الفاحشة لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم قط حتى يعلنوا بها إلا فشى بينهم الطاعون والأوجاع التي لم تكن في أسلافهم. That's the first one. ما تظهر الفاحشة when the zina, the فاحشة here means the zina, become normal and it becomes something that people practice without any fear, without any fear of Allah or taqwa, and they announce it and they publish it and they establish places for it, they give license for it, then what will happen? فَشَى فِيهُمْ الطَّاعُونَ, the plague, and وَالْأَوْجَاعُ الَّتِي لَمْ تَكُنْ فِي أَسْلَافِهِمْ and diseases and illnesses that were not in a previous generation. In new illnesses, in new diseases that they didn't experience before. The fahisha, the zina. People introduce, this is my partner. Ah, yes. Yes, Muslims, they introduce and they say, this is my partner, this is my girlfriend, this is my boyfriend. We are doing here self-reflection from a hadith in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Somebody live with somebody for a long time without any nikah, without any contract. And when you talk to them, it's fine. We are happy, our family is happy. That's the answer. Even to the extent one person has been now for 15 years. I said, brother, what is wrong? Just come to the masjid. It will take you 10, 15 minutes to make the nikah. 5 minutes, you will do it. Why? And people give different strange reasons why they do not want to get married and they live together without marriage. And this is the non-Muslim way. This is the non-Muslim way. And this is in different cultures is normal, but not in our deen. In our deen, it's haram, it is fahisha, it is musibah. It's a great fitna and a great test for the Muslim ummah. And this should start from young age. Educate our children. Marriage values and family values in Islam. It's something holy and secret, muqaddasa, and protected by the deen of Allah. Allah mentioned, mithaqan ghaliza. Mithaqan ghaliza. It's a strong, special contract and covenant when the person does the nikah. It's not just a piece of paper like some people say. Witnesses and the marriage mahar, the dowry and the ceremony and the announcement, the ishar, all these are format. But it is mithaqan ghaliza. These are confirmations of the submission of the will of Allah and His commands. We see now people go from non-Muslim countries to Muslim countries to do this. And they tell you with a bride. And countries that are supposed to establish Islam, they establish these areas for tourism. Tourism. To bring tours and people to visit the country and pay money and do haram. They provide alcohol for them. They provide these places for zina to refresh and strengthen the economy. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. No fear. It is musibah indeed that the Muslim country nowadays face it in many places. And this is the first thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us in this hadith. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and our children from this. Protect us and our children from this. Some people, they say it's very big. If somebody does underestimate and disrespect the rules of Allah with little things, then big things comes in our life. When you tell somebody you are chef and you are cooking pork, how this comes? Don't wait until you suffer and you see your children are making big haram, because you are already making it. You need to set good examples for them. When you say to somebody, stop selling alcohol, what you expect? and all the suffering that you will face, you and your family and all the Muslim Ummah because of you. Because from the sins of Muslims, other Muslims are suffering. Indeed. And some restaurants, they have a new fashion in Aberdeen. They say, we do not sell alcohol, but we allow people to bring their wine and alcohol with them. So they accommodate it, which is equal haram to sell it. Because they didn't see the ayat, they didn't see the hadith that made all of this equal. The one who drink it or sell it or buy it or witness it or write the contracts or pay the money or carry it or squeeze it or serve it or clean after it, they are all the same. They are all serving it and part of it. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the worst creation to Allah, the worst human, is those one who are on a table or around a table where alcohol served. And they say, we don't sell it, but why you have license to bring it in? We want to encourage Muslim businesses and inspire them and strengthen them and make them successful. Allah give the barakah and a blessing if they do the halal transaction and a practice indeed. Illnesses, the AIDS. The AIDS now even in Muslim countries, sadly. And these illnesses that we see day after day that we didn't hear about. Cancer, viruses comes. Every year you see different one. All this is punishment for the humanity and for the Muslim Ummah. Because they are accepting this to be part of their life. There are some nice, lovely, good Muslims who don't do that. But how much they stop it? How much they forbid the evil? How much they talk about it? How much they work to stop it? نسأل الله العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة وحسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. For those one who are doing this among the Muslim Ummah, destroying Muslim ladies and Muslim young men, and dragging them to the haram. Those one who will gain punishment in this dunya and in the akhirah, even after their death, all those people who were affected, they will gain the sayyi'at and burden of all the suffering and all the haram and fawahish that they established. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the second one, وَلَمْ يَنْقُصُ الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانَ إِلَّا أُخِذُوا بِالسِّنِينَ وَشِدَّةَ الْمَؤُونَ وَجَوْرِ السُّلْطَانِ عَلَيْهِمْ. They are cheating. When they are cheating in the scales and majors. Cheating. Cheating when they weight things. Cheating when they measure things. Cheat when they sell things, how much they put. They think if they take little of each one from each customer, they will make more money. They cheat in the quality when they buy the things, the stocks, and materials, and food, and services, items. They cheat in timing when they deliver the service. They cheat in the price by being unfair. They cheat even in the information. Nowadays, it's the era of information. If the person give half information, half declaration, twist the information, cheat in giving the truth, all this comes under this. Indeed. What the punishment? Illa ukhidu bis-sinin. The famine, hunger. Muslims, ummah, they are the most refugees in the whole world. The most refugees numbers in the whole world, the Muslim ummah. They are starving for water, starving for food and basic things. They don't have clothes. We see Muslim children are running naked in the snow and cold in many refugees areas and camps and in between countries' borders. This is punishment. Because the transactions are not honest. People are not honest in their transaction, their businesses. They lie, they cheat. They sell things off, expired, already expired. They don't eat it themselves. They don't take it home. Chicken off. They put some spices on it and they put it in the oven and sell it to customers who are trusting them. I'm giving examples. Engineers, they cheat as well. Teachers, they cheat when they waste the classes and they don't teach properly. People, when they do telephone calls in the time of work, unnecessary calls, or they read news instead of they do the work. So many types of cheating. In records, in meters, in calculations, in paying the tax or not, hiding the money or not. You sign a contract to pay tax, and then you hide the money and you don't pay tax. Why you sign the contract in the first place? Why you accepted to pay the tax in the first place? Why you actually did this business in the first place if you don't want to be honest and sincere and follow the Sharia of Islam? Giving excuses. This is zulm, this is too much, this is that. You accepted it. From the beginning, say, I don't want to do business because it's unfair to pay tax. Not to sign contract and then hide half or two-thirds of the money. All this comes under this, the cheating in majors. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, A'udhu billah, and tudrikuhunna. Subhanallah. Wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah. Now we are facing it, we experience it. Every second day people ask me these questions. I'm telling you from reality, from the truth of the Muslim daily practice. And when you talk to them and say, this is haram, but everyone doing it, what I should do? If I don't do it, I can't make money. I will lose. My business will lose. I can't survive with my children. Ya Allah. How a Muslim speak like this? Where is the trust on Allah? Where is the iman and aqeedah that Allah is al-Razzaq? Allah is al-Raziq. Allah created us and will not leave us. And if the business is not worth it, don't do it. Don't do it in the first place if you don't want to do it properly and honestly. That's why so many problems in our families. People really suffering. Pregnant young girls, they come to the mosque, what we do? They are crying. Where there's families? There are so many things we face every day here. Every week, so many divorces, in this community, in this city. And people say, why all this happening? Because our practices. Some of us are making the rest suffering by cheating in their majors. And if we don't stop it, the suffering will increase and continue. Because Allah gave us this clear mathematics formula. If you do this, this is what you face. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. The third one, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلَمْ يَمْنَعُوا زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ إِلَّا مُنُعُوا الْقَطْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَلَوْلَا الْبَهَائِمْ لَمْ يُمْطَرُوا. They withhold their zakah. Ya ikhwa, people ask me, they didn't pay zakah for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years in their businesses, life. Zakah is part of Islam. It's one of the main five pillars of Islam. Same as the prayer. They didn't pay the zakah and this didn't pay. If we pay our zakah, we will not suffer. We will not have people starving for food and water in the Muslim Ummah. Refugees everywhere. We need Baytu Maal al-Muslimin to collect this zakah and distribute it. And what the punishment? No rain comes. Allah will withhold the rain. Look at Muslim countries. They pray Salatul Istisqa, asking Allah for rain. Muslim countries are dry. And they are suffering from the rain. It's not Allah want to punish them. Allah want them to wake up and pay the zakah. So many wealthy Muslims in the world. The most wealthy people in the world are Muslims. And they are not paying their zakah. 2.5% of their wealth will make big difference. Indeed. Number 4. وَلَمْ يَنْقُضُوا عَهْدَ اللَّهِ وَعَهْدَ رَسُولِهِ إِلَّا سَلَّطَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ عَدُوًّا مِّنْ غَيْرِهِمْ فَأَخَذُوا بَعْضَ مَا فِي أَيْدِيهِمْ. Number 4. Look, it's we are living in this. If they do not follow the covenant, the ahd of Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then what will happen? Allah will send them enemy, adu, enemy. Not from them. This is external enemy. Listen carefully, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, words very accurate. عَدُوًا مِّنْ غَيْرِهِمْ. Not among them. مِّنْ غَيْرِهِمْ. The one among them will come in the last one. But listen. عَدُوًا مِّنْ غَيْرِهِمْ فَأَخَذُوا بَعْضَ مَا فِي أَيْدِيهِمْ. And they will steal their wealth. They will take some of their wealth. Not all of it. Is it clear? بَعْضِ مَا فِي أَيْدِيهِمْ. The oil and gas. Resources of Muslim Ummah. The cash, where is the cash of the Muslim Ummah? All the wealthy Muslims, where is their investments? Where is this cash? All outside. Gone. And the adu asking for money. What is asking for? Money. You have to bring money or we will come and destroy you. And the adu is threatening the Muslim Ummah to take their money so they can save them and protect them. And they do. And millions and millions and billions and trillions taken from the Muslim Ummah, wealthy people, by the adu. And Allah call him adu. Allah call him enemy. And the last one. وَمَا لَمْ تَحْكُمْ أَئِمَّتَهُمْ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ وَيَتَخَيَّرُوا مِمَّا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ بَأْسَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. Ya Allah. If their leaders, they don't rule them by the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they choose from the ahkam of the sharia when they rule and decide about things, then what will happen? Fitna among them. Muslims killing Muslims. The killer doesn't know why he's killing, and the one who is killed doesn't know why he's killed. This internal fitna, because we do not rule our nation by the book of Allah and the sharia of Islam. Very clear. I will read it again. وَمَا لَمْ تَحْكُمْ أَئِمَّتَهُمْ, meaning the leaders and rulers, if they do not rule them بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ, by the book of Allah, وَيَتَخَيَّرُ مِمَّا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ, and they choose from the ahkam of Islam when they decide about things. إِلَّا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ بَأْسَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. What's the punishment? Then their power will be, and their fitna and their fighting and dispute and conflict will be among each other. So many enmities, so many problems among the Muslim Ummah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us from these five things, these five fitan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people of the salihat, those people of the peace and security, those people of the sharia, those people of the good deeds, to spread the sharia and the deen of Allah. And join the ma'ruf, join the good, and forbid the evil, the munkar. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفر. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. A great gift from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنه رضي الله عنهما عن ابن عباس وعن أبيه العباس عم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah used to say this dua a lot, and it is important to learn it and teach it to your family. Even one of the scholars said that this should be written by words of gold and silver. And the Muslim Ummah should be taught this because it has a great meanings and aqidah. رب أعني ولا تعن علي. Oh Allah, help me and don't make anyone to be helped against me. This include yourself, this include your shaitan, this include other bad people, this include protection for you and your family. وَانْصُرْنِي وَلَا تَنْصُرْ عَلَيْ. Oh Allah, give me the victory and don't give the victory against me. وَامْكُرْ لِي وَلَا تَمْكُرْ عَلَيْ. And make the plotting and planning with me and for me, to work for me. And don't make the plotting and planning by others against me. This include hasad, include jinn, include magic, include all other type of plotting that people do. When people try to harm you in any way, but Allah will protect you indeed. Wahdini, and guide me. Wa yassir al-huda ilay. Ihdini, guide me to the huda. So I go to the guidance. يسر الهدى إلي means that open doors of huda for me, even that I didn't think about. Bring the huda to me. Somebody come and tell you something, somebody send you something, and then that open door of hidayah for you. وانصرني على من بغى علي. And give me the upper hand and make me overtake and give me the victory against those one who made zulm against me, made oppression against me. رَبِّ جَعَلِّي لَكَ شَكَّارًا. Oh Allah, make me, not just make shukr, now شَكَّارًا. And this is عَلَى وَزِن فَعَالًا, means I make shukr a lot and all the time. Oh Allah, make me grateful and thankful from the heart and tongue and mind, and also from my practice. Protect my ni'mah and increase it. Make me use it in khair. That's what shakaran means. All the time I am happy and satisfied and content. Laka dhakaran. Not just make dhikr, but actually make dhikr a lot. Laka rahaban. When I pray, I do nawafil and ibadat and qiyam layl and dhikr and tasbih. Rahaban. In the depth of the ibadah, khushu', focused, dedicate time for you, ya Allah. Laka mitwa'an, obedient. It's not just I obey you. No, more than that. I am hastened to obey you. I am just running for obeying you. Sami'na wa ata'na. When I hear something, I just do it. No hesitation. Mitwa'an ilayka, mukhbitan lak. Always coming back. Awahan muniban. Always coming to you. Always connecting with you, Ya Allah. This is amazing hadith by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rabbi taqabbal tawbati. Oh Allah, accept my tawbah. Waghsil hawbati. And clean me from all these bad deeds. وأجب دعوتي and accept my dua. وثبت حجتي and strengthen me and my position. واهد قلبي and made my heart steadfast and strong. وسدد لساني and make my tongue speak only good and truth. واشلل سخيمة قلبي and oh Allah, make my heart full with iman. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who learn this great hadith, hadith sahih, في السلسلة الصحيحة, and to learn it. رب اجعلني لك شكارا لك ذكارا لك رهابا لك مطواعا إليك مخبتا إليك أواها منيبا رب أعني ولا تعن على. Amazing دعاء. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يجعلنا من أهل هذا الدعاء. آمين يا رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم عنا على فعل الطاعات وترك المنكرات اللهم احينا مسلمين وتوفنا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم احفظ المسلمين في فلسطين واحفظ المسجد الأقصى يا رب العالمين وبيت المقدس يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم كن مع المسلمين في ليبيا وفي اليمن وفي العراق وفي كشمير وفي الصين يا رب العالمين اللهم يا ربنا وفي اليمن وفي كل مكان وفي كشمير وفي بورما اللهم كن مع المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم كن مع المسلمين في كل مكان برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.